What do I do with my life? Career choices, choosing the right friends, what college to attend. Yet all these decisions are empty when they're not anchored in a sense of destiny. It's time you start letting purpose guide your life. It's time to discover your God-given design to press into your full potential. City Church is a spirit-filled church with a rich heritage of ministry in the city of New Orleans and is known for miracles, signs, and wonders. City Church partners with Southeastern University at Lakeland, Florida to provide students with a practical ministry training environment along with an affordable accredited degree program. City College exists to equip you for your kingdom purpose, whether that's in the marketplace or ministry. Let us help you strengthen your relationship with God and prepare you to bring the power of God to your world. The semester begins September 28th. Apply today at citycollegenola.org or text FALL21 to 504-500-0809.
Welcome to City Church TV. As always, it's wonderful to be with you tonight. And we're going to have some exciting things to talk about tonight. You know, I often find art interesting. Looking at different pieces of art is so interesting. And just recently, I found a piece of art that I really liked, and the painter happened to be from Louisiana. So I was able to get in touch with the actual artist who created that piece of art, and he ended up creating a piece for us. And how interesting it was and how special that piece of art is, because we got to know a lot about it from the artist himself. And that's just like our God in concerns with our purpose. If you really want to know what your purpose is, don't just go to anyone to find out. Go to the person who actually created you, which is our Father God. He created us, and He knows every detail of everything of our lives. In fact, He, Owen, is the one who designed us with our gifts, with our makeup, everything about us. He designed us with our purpose and intent in mind. So how important it is that we go to the Creator Himself, our Father, Jesus Christ.
Well, using that example, of the particular artist that we get a chance to meet, and just by happenstance, she shot this man an email, and he wrote back. And I think what the analogy is that when we talked to him about the specific painting, he began to tell us what he saw.
Right.
And no one can explain a piece of art.
No.
Like the artist himself. And I think that's the same with discovering our purpose.
Yeah.
And we've been talking about this for a few weeks now, and this is actually our last series on this this subject called To Purpose and how to discover your purpose. I think if you want to know the original intent of the painting, or the original intent of a creation, which is mankind, you have to go to the person who created it.
Yeah.
And just like when we met that artist, he was actually—
His name is Dustin Russo.
Yeah, he's a great guy.
Yes, great guy.
And he described to us what he was painting. Now, we didn't see it. We just liked the image.
Right.
And it was abstract. That's why, you know, it's abstract modern art.
Yeah.
So you have to really get into the mind of the artist to figure out what was he seeing and what was his interpretation. And I think that's like our purpose. It's abstract. It's difficult in the natural to understand what we are originally created to do. But I think that's the difference. So purpose, we can say, is not discovered. I can remember going to college and I changed my major 3 times, maybe 4 times. I don't know. I just never did really know.
I'm sure your parents loved you for that.
Well, I was on the 10-year plan. And, you know, Dad said, listen, you either go to work or you're going to go to school. If you don't go to school, you get a job.
So you were a professional student.
Well, I just said, I'm just going to milk this as long as I can.
Why not?
And because I know once you start working, it never ends. But, I mean, going to school, you're 18. I was 17 when I first went to college, the first semester. I didn't know what I wanted to do.
No.
Of course, you're going to take math and English and all that stuff. But what happens is that we meet this individual, we meet this other person, they inspire us, mm-hmm. and all that's fantastic. But that really is not how you discover what God intends for you.
Yeah.
If you want to discover your purpose, you need a revelation.
You do.
And revelation is information that's given to you by the Holy Spirit.
Yes, yes.
John 16, verse 13 says, however, when he, the Spirit of truth, has come, he will guide you into all truth. Mm-hmm. For he will not speak of his own authority, whatever he hears, he will speak, and he will tell you things to come. So God does give us these natural indicators, and we talked about that. Mm-hmm. However, we need a revelation from the Holy Spirit to give us understanding of the natural indicators.
Right.
So this is how we can confirm what we're supposed to do. And I pray that those who have been watching us for week and week in and week out, that you understand that true fulfillment only comes when you're doing what God created you to do.
Correct.
Most people, here's the sad thing, they go through life, they get into adulthood, and they really never, ever, mm-hmm. God's gonna hold us accountable for that.
Right.
Now, I'm not just being difficult and harsh, but we need to discover through revelation what God wants us
yeah.
to do. As a kid going to college, I can remember that the Holy Spirit began to speak to me about what I was to do.
Mm-hmm.
And I had fought it. I didn't want to do what I'm doing here. I had other aspirations, other goals, other dreams. But when I started walking with the Lord, I just started asking him. And that's my first point, Tammy. Mm-hmm. The first point is you got to get to know God.
You do.
You got to stop and say, Lord God, what do you want me to do? And listen, he will tell you.
He will.
Jesus said, my sheep know my voice,
mm-hmm.
and a stranger they will not. If you don't know the voice of God, could it be that you don't really know God yet?
Right.
So we need to get to know him. That's mm-hmm. That's the first thing. When I got to know the Lord, even though I had been raised in a church, been raised in a Christian home, but when I came to know the Lord,
yeah.
and I had an encounter with the Lord,
mm-hmm.
he spoke to me. He
right.
said to me, he downloaded understanding
right.
in my mind. Now, I didn't know it all. I just knew I had to do something. And of course, I've seen it over and over. It comes to you in pieces.
Yes.
Everything that you're supposed to do doesn't come to you at one time.
No.
You get a little bit from God and you follow that.
Right.
And then you finish that one and then he says mm-hmm. some more. But where most people miss it, they feel like if they go to college,
mm-hmm.
if I go to university, I'll surely find
well,
out.
I think what happens is
that will never happen.
So many people make life decisions based on what benefits them. And of course in life, you are to put your best foot forward and you are to work hard. And we know that hard work pays off. So I'm not against hard work. I'm not against making something of yourself. But
right.
so many times we're so putting ourselves as the priority and we're putting ourselves ahead of the Lord that sometimes we need to back up and say, Lord, what is your will to be done? Whatever career or whatever that you would have me to go into, wherever I'm to work, whatever school I'm to go to, all these life decisions, where is it that you want me to be that my life will bring glory
right.
to you? Because we all have spheres of influence. So if you're a nurse and you go in and you become a nurse, on that job, God will bring people in your path that you are to be a light to. If you're a teacher, God will bring students into your path that you're gonna be a light to. So
right.
it's not just all about, okay, Where's the highest paying job, and that's where I'm gonna go because that's what's gonna benefit me. It all coincides together, sure. The work of the Lord.
And that's why it's important for us.
The will of God.
To know God, to discover and the plan of God revealed to us for our purpose.
Yes.
The original intent is we need to get to know God. How do you get to know God? I can take it real simple. Don't make it mysterious. Let's be very pragmatic. The Word of God.
Yeah.
The Bible. You just get you a Bible.
And read it.
And read. You say, where? Just read anything.
Every day.
I say read Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, the Gospels. But today I was reading in 2 Chronicles. And of course, I've been reading the Bible for a very long time. But I have read the story of Hezekiah and the invading armies of Assyria probably 120 times.
Right.
But today, reading it once again, what came to me was simply trust in the Lord.
Yeah.
Trust in the Lord. All of Sennacherib and all of the opposing kings were telling Hezekiah, you're going down. And Hezekiah told the people, do not listen to those voices. Listen to what I'm saying. Believe the prophets and prosper.
Yes, yes.
And they didn't say anything. And guess what happened? They never had to fight one battle. Mm. Hezekiah, the opposing army from Assyria, that king, got a call to go back to Assyria. Mm-hmm. And when he got to Assyria, guess what happened? They assassinated him.
Yeah.
So Israel, Judah, never had to fire one arrow. My point is, trust in the Lord.
Yes.
Now, it's just simple. But you're like, those are just an example of like, when you read the Word of God.
Yes.
It speaks to us.
Well, there are so many wonderful tools today. Like there are apps on your phone, the Bible app, and there are reading plans. And I find that easy because it just basically organizes your reading for you. There's subject matters. There's if you want to stay in one book of the Bible. I love the Bible apps that with the reading plans.
Yeah. I mean, your written Word of God, prayer. Of course, we go deeper at fasting. We meet the Lord at the holy table of communion, the Eucharist.
Yes.
We meet him there and we get to know him. This is a relationship.
Mm-hmm.
God wants a relationship with us, and he has provided a way because he gave us Jesus.
Yes.
But it is up to us to meet him at those places. And this is how we discover our purpose through revelation. Abraham, he said this, David said this in Psalms 25, verse 14. The secret of the Lord is with those who fear him, and he will show them his covenant.
Yes.
Abraham came into an intimate relationship with the Lord, and he was just a heathen.
Yeah.
He was a pagan. He didn't even know God.
No, right.
No one knew God. But when God spoke to Abraham, and Abraham, he said, Abraham, get up from where you are in this country and go to a new land. Abraham came to know him little by little by little, but it started somewhere. And Abraham, being the father of our faith, God began to tell him everything.
Yeah.
Prophesied to him about his descendants. God spoke to him about 400 years that his family would go into captivity.
Mm-hmm.
This is amazing. God would speak to him from five or six generations before what would happen.
Mm.
But it didn't happen. It wasn't that clear when he first started walking with the Lord. He started somewhere.
Yes.
And if we're going to know our purpose, we're going to have to get to know
God. Well, tell
me.
If someone is looking for a good church to plug into.
Well, we're going to talk about that.
Tell me about
that. Because my next point really talks about that. So let's just stop. We got some things that are happening here at City Church, and we want to share them with you. And when we come back, I believe one of the most important things that will help you to understand your purpose in God.
City Church is expanding. For anyone who feels that City Church is their home, but lives abroad or outside the greater New Orleans area, you can now be a part of our online church campus. This e-church experience has many benefits, including but not limited to pastoral care, online belong groups, opportunities to grow spiritually, and serve on Sunday in our online service. To find out more about online church and meet some of our team members, check out our website at citychurchnola.life. What do I do with my life? Career choices, choosing the right friends, what college to attend. Yet all these decisions are empty when they're not anchored in a sense of destiny. It's time you start letting purpose guide your life. It's time to discover your God-given design to press into your full potential. City Church is a spirit-filled church with a rich heritage of ministry in the city of New Orleans and is known for miracles, signs, and wonders. City Church partners with Southeastern University at Lakeland, Florida, to provide students with a practical ministry training environment, along with an affordable accredited degree program. City College exists to equip you for your kingdom purpose, whether that's in the marketplace or ministry. Let us help you strengthen your relationship with God and prepare you to bring the power of God to your world. The semester begins September 28th. Apply today at citycollegenola.org or text FALL21 to 504-500-0809. Belong groups are a great way to connect with others while growing in your walk with God in an intimate setting. We encourage you to join a Belong group to help take you to the next level in God. Our Belong hosts whole groups all throughout the week in person and around the city of New Orleans and virtually via Zoom. Get connected today by visiting our website at citychurchnola.life. Would you like to rewatch Bishop's messages each week and keep up with what's going on here at City Church? If so, head over to our YouTube channel to see the latest sermon series, short stories, City Church TV episodes, and so much more. Subscribe to our YouTube channel today by searching City Church of New Orleans. Becoming a part of a local church is the start of a new journey in your walk with God. We believe that being a part of God's family is one of the biggest blessings in life. Planning your life here at City Church will equip and encourage you to flourish in all areas of life, in family, relationships, servanthood, and your personal relationship with God. If you would like to become a member, we've made it much easier. Become a member by completing a simple form online at citychurchnola.life or text the keyword JOIN to 504-500-0809. We look forward to hearing from you soon.
I want to make the statement right as we start coming back from our infomercial session there. You can't soar like an eagle if you hang with the chickens.
Uh-oh, that's good.
You want to know your purpose.
Yes.
You're gonna need to get to know God.
Yes.
But secondly, you gotta be in the right environment. So what does that mean?
Go to church.
You gotta get in church.
Yes.
That's where God speaks to us.
No doubt.
Now if you're in a church where you don't hear
the
Holy Spirit speaking to you, then maybe you need to get to a place where the tangible, manifest presence of God can be felt, sensed, and experienced. Some churches have it. I'm not naming churches that don't, but there are places where the Holy Spirit is so real that you can't help but know that you're encountering Almighty God. His presence is everywhere. We go to the mountains, he's there in those ranges. We go to the bayou, we were riding down a few days ago down in the bayou where you were from and my family were from in St. Bernard Parish. How beautiful all the oak trees and the cypress, the moss. It's just beautiful, that part of the world. And you can experience God. But that is a omnipresence of the Lord, where we can sense through creation he's real.
Yeah.
But then there are moments where God's tangible presence can be felt on our physical person. And in that moment, we can hear
yes.
what he wants to say to us. This is why we come to church, because he promises that he will be there with us mm-hmm. when two or three are gathered and they're
Absolutely.
Worshiping him in the name of the Lord Jesus. So to fulfill our purpose, Tammy, we must be in the right
environment. You know how important it is to go to the right church? Here at City Church, it's very touching. We have people that come from as far as Biloxi every Sunday. They drive, they live in Biloxi, St. Rose, all of the major outskirts that seem to be a distance. And I've talked to these wonderful members of our church, yeah. and they said, this is where God called them. This is where they belong. And they are willing to make the drive. Well, so finding that right place.
If you're in a depressed environment.
Yes.
All of the time, you're not going to hear God.
Yes.
You say, well, because it's the enemy doesn't want you to hear the Lord's voice.
Right.
So we need to find a way
yeah.
to get to the place. This is, you can take this principle and apply it to anything. Even mentally, mm-hmm. if you want to succeed, you've got to be in the right environment.
Yeah.
This is the difference from teams that win and teams that lose.
Right.
There's a good environment in the locker room.
Yeah.
There's a good environment. There's good positive discussion and talk.
Right.
When guys are together, people are together. But if you get someone who brings dissent.
That's right.
That environment will eventually, it will affect you.
Yes, it will.
Now, we take that to the spirit,
how much more important.
The same thing, but more, like you said, more important.
Yeah.
That we are in the right environment. This is what has happened to a lot of people today. Because of COVID, because of whatever has gone on, individuals have decided, oh, I don't really need that environment.
I
can make it on my own.
Right.
And the truth is, that is a lie from the wicked one.
That's right.
We need one another, but it's bigger than that. When we come together, the environment that is
yes.
created, when there's worship, when there's praise, when there's songs of jubilee, when there's exaltation, the lifting up of the Lord, and the falling and coming of the Holy Spirit, things begin to shift in your life.
That's right.
Positive thoughts.
No doubt.
Anointing flows, and you say, man, I will live and not die.
Yes.
I am going to prosper and not fail.
Yes.
I'm above and not below. I am the righteousness of Jesus
yes.
Christ. And all of that begins to shift in your life.
Yes.
Then you hear his voice and you obey and you step into prosperity.
Amen.
You step in to another
no doubt.
Dynamic aspect of your life. So you can see this. Here we have belong groups, we have mm-hmm. we have relationships, all of these things, your friends
youth
and your
ministry,
associates.
Children's ministry, just every avenue for people to really, really plug in and belong in their local church.
The people you spend time with mm-hmm. is determining your ability to hear the voice of God.
Yes.
The right. So tonight, if you recognize that you're not in the right environment,
yeah.
don't just pass it off
right.
and say, well, it's not bothering me. Yes, it is. You will be hindered from achieving your purpose,
That's
from
it.
Being in the wrong environment. It is that serious.
Yes.
That serious to be in the right place.
And this is for somebody. If you've experienced church hurt and that has you out of church, get back in church. There's no better place to heal than in the house of the
yeah.
Lord. It's time for you to heal. It's time for you to be made whole, because God still has great things for your life. That's for somebody tonight.
And Jamie, when you get into that environment, my last point is this. Serve
yes.
a vision.
Yes.
Serve a vision. Not just being in the house, but be involved in
yeah.
the house. Serve somebody else be included in what is going on. And then God will begin to entrust you.
Correct.
With your own
vision.
I have seen that. As I have walked with the Lord and served other ministers, other leaders, God has opened the door to speak to me about what I need to do in the next step.
Yeah.
But so many people are just kind of waiting on God.
Yes.
God wants you to not just wait. Of course, there's an aspect of waiting, but he wants us to be engaged in what we can do. That means serve him. Serve him where you are.
Where you are.
It may seem small, but when you are faithful with the small things, God will reward you.
Absolutely.
With the bigger things.
Absolutely.
I believe that the purpose of God is the utmost, number one subject that we can talk about.
Yes.
Because I believe that if we're doing the purpose of God, that's where we'll find prosperity.
Everything else falls in place.
That's where we find health.
Yes.
That's where we find... I'm not saying it's going to be a easy road. And it's not never...
No.
Nothing good's never easy.
No.
The best treasure is deep.
Yes, it is.
The best treasure. Nothing in life that's good.
Yeah.
Comes easy, but to find the purpose of God, you got to fight, you got to desire it, go after it with all your heart, and God will reveal it to you.
Isn't it amazing?
Your life will take
on fulfillment.
When
we take one step, how God will take two.
He will.
If we just sit back and do nothing and we expect God to do so much, God's saying, "No, I'm waiting on you. Where are you at? I'm waiting on you to step up. I'm waiting on your pursuit." And then when you pursue God, when you draw near to God, he'll draw near to you.
He will. And I believe tonight we hit on that right environment.
Yes.
I think that that's the key for the evening.
We want to see you.
And you need to get in church.
Yes.
One for us, one great opportunity on a Sunday, 10 a.m. We're located in New Orleans. Mm-hmm. At 13123 I-10 Service Road. You can't miss it. It's big, white top. I mean, it sticks out like a...
You can't miss us.
Yeah, we would like to see it. And if you can, join us in person. We have so many platforms that you can join us online. Be a part, be involved. And again, that environment to fulfill our purpose, we must be...
Yes.
In the right environment, spiritually, mentally, emotionally, physically, and geographically.
Yes.
I believe the location and the place is utmost of importance. So we'll see you at church. I want to meet you and greet you. It's been a joy. Remember, God has a purpose for you. But until next time, have a blessed, blessed week.
Thank you for tuning in to City Church TV. You can follow us on Facebook, YouTube, and Instagram at City Church NOLA or visit our website at citychurchnola.com. Tune into our services via live stream on Sundays at 10 a.m. and you can also join us for morning prayer on Wednesdays at 7 a.m. and family time on Wednesdays at 7 p.m. Until next time, have a great week.